It's a hockey night in Pittsburgh. Tonight, from the PPG Paints Arena in downtown Pittsburgh, PA, the National Hockey League presents the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Calgary Flames. And gets it up for Olimana, who will drive it into the Calgary zone. Shea in a collision here as he went for the puck with Kulak, the defenseman. Moved to the center point. Penguins with it. Ruino will shot. He shoots and scores. Chad Ruino from 63 feet away. Snapped it by Gillies, and the Penguins get the first goal and lead 1-0. Oh, I want to see a silly sail sliding sideways in Sausalito. Ruino gets the Penguins running.
And there was a penalty coming up to the Flames, Mikey, on Dougie Hamilton for taking out a Penguin in front of the net. But the wicked wrister by Ruino, it fools Gillies on the blocker side. Might have even gone six hole, but this all started with a great forecheck by Riley Sheahan. Then you had puck support from Phil Kessel. And Mikey, what a pass by Phil Kessel. He literally threaded the needle to go from the far corner, threw a couple sticks, threw a couple legs, right onto the stick of Chad Ruino. Ruino takes a little step to his right to get a shooting lane. Lots of traffic in front. It finds a six hole on Gillies, and it's 1-0 Pens.
Ruino will get the goal, and Kessel helps setting up the play as the Penguins ram it in behind the Calgary net. 6'3" goaltender. Gillies lost the puck and tried. The Penguins have scored right in front of the net. Malkin's going to get credit for this goal as the goaltender Gillies wants to play it. And it's Malkin who finds it and he puts it in. The Penguins have a 2-0 lead.
Holy moly. Well, if it's going good, it goes really good for the Penguins. And John Gillies goes in behind the net to play the puck. I don't know if Malkin gets a stick on this or if it just goes on the shin guards as he comes in to forecheck Gillies. Gillies tries to rip it along the boards. He throws it right into Evgeny Malkin, and before Gillies can get back into the cage, it's in the net. Gino does get a stick on it. It bounces off his body, off the defenseman Brody, onto the stick of Malkin, and before Gillies can get back, it's 2-0 Pens.
And the Tang has a stick here. And a hard blast towards the net, picked up, knocked down, rebound. And Brower can't finish. He put it up the side of the net. Flames again with some good pressure, shooting and scoring. And that one was just a shot that the goaltender Jari was screened on. It was Giordano getting the puck on the short side. And I don't think Jari saw it at all.
Well, a smart play by Mark Giordano. The Penguins, and you mentioned no stick for Letang. And the Penguins were out of gas, Mikey. They couldn't move. They're in their defensive, stuck in their defensive zone. And what a smart play by the captain, Mark Giordano, to just with a couple layers of screen there. He spins off a check and just wrists it short side on Tristan Jarry. It finds a hole between the blocker and the post to the right of Jarry. And that cuts the lead in half. It's now 2-1.
That's a big goal.
It is a huge goal.
Showed me something there from this Calgary team. Yep. They're coming back, boy. They're not rolling over. They're coming to play hockey.
You mentioned, Dougie Hamilton with 14. Now Giordano with 11 goals. He got 25 from those two guys on the backside. And it was Giordano that broke the Penguins' heart up in Calgary with the OT winner against Tristan Jarry.
They're going to stride back now to their own blue line and reset. And it's a pass up for Michael Folik. Folik, left side to back one. In and out move against Letang. Comes in on goal. Beats Jarry with another great move. And Michael Backlund ties this game at 2. You can't do any better than he did there. He went through the whole team.
Oh, what a goodness gracious. Chris Letang, he just wants to get off the ice right now. How do you do? Curl and drag. See you later. Holy moly, what a move Michael Backlund just put on Chris Letang. I don't know what was better, the move he put on Letang or the finish he put on Jarry. Holy moly. As Chris Letang went for the puck, and it was almost like Backlund had it on a yo-yo, Mikey. He said, here you go, see you later, curl, drag, and then forehand, backhand, shelf on Tristan Jarry. What an individual effort from Michael Backlund. We're tied at 2.
That was a thing of beauty. And it turns around right by the check of Haglund, goes right side, Hathaway with it, got a man in front, a quick shot to the net, and a good save there. But Jankowski got a great opportunity, back to the goal, and Jarry again on Hathaway. Two big saves, Jankowski and Hathaway, And Jari snapped both of them.
Oh, my goodness. What a save by Tristan Jari with the right pad. Tell you what, Mikey, the Flames have righted the ship, and they are coming guns a-blazing. The two-on-one, and Tristan Jari flashes out the right pad. Jankowski had to get that up.
I'm going to bring the face up outside of the, to the right of goaltender Jari.
Like I'm watching a replay, he did get it up a little bit. Jari moving from his left to right. He got that blocker right on top of the pad on Jankowski and robbed him to keep it 2-2.
Pumpkin wins that draw cleanly, pulled it back almost to his own goal. Hagelin takes it, now gives it back to Evgeny Malkin. Malkin to the right side, beautiful pass. Here comes Letang, shooting and scoring from the right wing circle, and the Penguins have taken the lead 3-2. Oh, get that dog off my lawn. Malkin, the beautiful lead pass to Letang, snapped it, and the Penguins have the lead.
Oh, Mikey, I couldn't have said it any better. That pass by Evgeny Malkin, there's so much to it. Chris Letang just uses his speed to basically just beat the Calgary Flames forwards up the ice. It all started with a good little outlet pass from Carl Hagelin to Evgeny Malkin. Then Gino does all the heavy lifting. He carries the puck out of the zone, through the neutral zone. Meanwhile, Letang is flying down the right wing. But Malkin then gears down in the neutral zone and a perfectly tempoed pass to catch Chris Letang in full stride. And Giordano crosses over a couple times, Mikey, and he's flat-footed. Chris Letang with a wicked wrister from the right dot goes up over the right shoulder of the goaltender Gillies. It's 3-2 Pens.
Sensational. I guess that's the word I want to use, seriously. Here, he's done it all year long. Here down the left side is Brody. Brody comes in, threw it in front. Brower scores, and we've got a tie game. Troy Brower set up there in a beautiful play by T.J. Brody. And guess what, folks? With 2.4 seconds to go in the second, we're all tied again.
That one hurts. Boy, that one hurts. 2.4 left. And why not? As a defenseman, join the rush. Brody goes wide on Olli Mäta just as he's getting to the goal line. It's four white jerseys against three black jerseys. And a perfect pass by Brody right between the legs of Ruedel. Backdoor to Brower. He's got a wide open cage. No chance for Jari at all. And we are tied at three.
Goal number five on the year for Brower. Penguins in their own end. Oleksiak around for Hagelin, who fell down. And the Flames start the play behind the net. Back one in front. A little short pass and a stop there by Jari at the last second on Tkachuk. Oh, that was close.
Oh, Michael Backlund. Mikey, we don't see enough of the Calgary Flames to appreciate Michael Backlund. This guy's got skill off the charts. Working down low below the goal line. He's being hunted down by Hagelin. I really thought he was going to go for the wraparound. And then as he's almost going for the wraparound, he goes on the forehand, behind the back, right to Tkachuk. And somehow Tristan Jari is able to keep his left foot up against the left post and rob Tkachuk.
Then was another big face-off win, this time by Derek Brassard. And a shot deep up into the Flames end. It comes off the body of Gillies. Did it go in or not? Right around that goal line, play is whistled down. It came off of Gillies, and one of the Flames came racing in. I thought for a moment may have knocked the puck into his own net and pulled it out.
I want to look at this one. This one went through the body of Gillies as he reached back, Mikey. I don't know. He reached back with a stick. Giordano had a stick right there. This is about a 180-foot clear that Gillies misplayed. He had his paddle in behind the goal line. Oh, baby, we need to take another look at this one here to see if the puck is 100% over the line. No, it's not.
I don't think it is.
It's not. Oh, man, it can't get any closer. As that puck dribbled between Gillies' body, and then his left skate kicked it back into his own goal. And while it was dancing on the goal line, he was able to reach back with his paddle. What awareness by Gillies to feel where that puck was with the help of Giordano. And Mikey, this puck flips up on edge and is literally tiptoeing through the tulips on the goal line. No goal.
Kessel comes forward. Passing left wing. Up for Malkin, just inside the blue line. Goes cross rink. Open man now, and it's Kessel. Goes left side here. Schultz shooting and scoring! Justin Schultz gets the goal set up by Kessel, and the Penguins have won it in overtime. The kitchen is closed. The defenseman Schultz finishes it from 25 feet. 4-3, the Penguins win.
Oh, that is skill off the charts. That is ridiculous what we just witnessed with that skill there. Let's start with the long bank stretch pass by Phil Kessel, the spring of Evgeny Malkin. Malkin gains his own, hits the brakes, spinorama move inside the blue line. He sends a, I don't mind telling you, I was holding my breath on this, cross-ice backhand pass that Phil Kessel flagged down with the glove hand, and he then sends it backdoor to Justin Schultz, who got away from the defenseman Giordano. And a one-timer by Schultz. No chance for the goaltender Gillies for the overtime winner.
So the Penguins end up with another overtime win here on this homestand. And Kessel setting up Schultz for what proved to be the goal that sent everybody home. And your final score, the Penguins 4 and Calgary 3.